I'll be discussing now BI applications in detail. The following are some of the areas of applications of business intelligence and data mining. We'll discuss these one by one. Customer relationship management, CRM, a commonly used software also by different organizations, CRM. Healthcare and wellness. Then your education industry, in your retailing or retail marketing, banking, financial services, insurance and insurance companies, manufacturing companies, telecom and government. So we discuss how these BI applications, you can say how that they are giving an effective kind of decision making in all these scenarios. First, customer relationship management. A business exists to serve a customer. Everyone knows it. A business exists to serve a customer. Until unless you don't have a customer, how are you going to get earn your money? So that means, so if you are giving or serving a customer in one way or the other, then only you will be getting your business. That means you will earn profits. A happy customer becomes a repeat customer. And if you are able to satisfy your customer, he or she will definitely return to you only for the similar kind of purchases. So that's why that's a very that plays a very important role in your going of your running of your business. So under it, what we'll do is we'll discuss that what kind of things we have to concentrate on now. Maximize the returns on marketing campaigns. So we have to see that your return on marketing campaigns should be very high. So in that case, your marketing campaigns should be dedicated or keep should be planned in such a way that you should be very clear what kind of customer you have to target. Suppose your products are only for the students. So that means whatever marketing campaign you have to run or you have to execute, that should only be based on the student. And if your products are only for the students who are doing your graduation or post-graduation, means those who are grown-ups. So in that case, your marketing campaign should definitely be based on the criteria that would definitely help target only the students who are, let's say, age 15 years or 16 years above. So that helps you to have a, you can say, view of what kind of marketing campaign you have to implement or execute. Next important point is improve customer retention. That is even called as your churn analysis. Now it is very difficult and expensive even to win new customers. So if you have to add new customers to your this business, that is of course a difficult task. And the second important difficult task is to retain the existing customers. So if you have a good customer relationship, if you are providing good service to your this customer, definitely he or she will definitely remain with you. You are able to retain your customer. So if I take an example now, you planned for a, let's say, any one of the Wi-Fi company to provide your Wi-Fi to at your home. So as and when you started up, you started facing some problems. You called up those people who are a complaint, but you were not satisfied with the time that they took for your solving your problem. Plus, they might not be able to solve your problem immediately, and you faced a lot of problem in handling those people. So in that case, that customer, that means you might not give a very positive view of the company or organization. Plus, they will not, as an organization, they will not be able to retain the customer who has already joined you. So that means if you are able to provide good after service, if you are able to provide good after service to your customers, in that case, you are able to retain your customers. Second important is if you want to add up new customers, in that case, you need to have a very good policy, or you can say very good discounts, or in the form of some kind of incentives to be provided to the already existing customers who are attached with some other organizations who are providing Wi-Fi facility. So you it's a very difficult task over here. So again, this is a very important factor in case of CRM. How to retain your old customers and how to add new customers to your this organization. Another important is maximize the customer value. cross-selling and upselling. So even the so every contact with the customer should be seen as an opportunity over here now. If you get a complaint call from your customer, that means that's an opportunity to provide the service in a very good way to your customer, so that your customer start giving good feedback to the people around him, and you definitely would definitely have a good number of customers attached to you further also. Suppose I am very much satisfied with one of the company of which I have this Wi-Fi facility, and even in case of any problem, I was very much satisfied with the service that was provided, and at a very short interval of time, I was able to they were able to solve my problem. So I would definitely recommend it to my anyone who asked me that what kind of Wi-Fi facility you have and which company is better. I would tell them that yes, of course I am attached to this company and I'm satisfied with that company because they provided me with a good solution in a very less amount of time. And of course, their people, they visited me and they were able to give me a good satisfied response in terms of my solution of to my problem. So in that case, that's called as cross-selling now. You are, by providing a good service to a customer, you are indirectly cross-selling. Cross-selling means adding new customers in one way or the other. I would definitely tell one or two persons, you go for this company in case of I. Another is identify and delight highly valued customers. Some customers, they are considered as high value. High value means they have good reputation in the society. And that person, if it is attached to your company, you should definitely identify them. You should definitely value those customers, because those customers are those who are actually followed by a large number of people in the society. So if you are able to take their attention, provide them with better services, and you provide them with your, let's say, effective services and efficient services in, whenever they need it, that means they, those customers who are definitely valued customers for you, they would definitely help you to your business to grow by adding more customers to your organization. Another important factor is manage your brand image. A business can create a listing post to listen to the social media chatters about itself, and it can then do sentiment analysis also. Now what happens over here is, here for this you have a department who continuously see the feedback given in the social media regarding you, your organization, your services. So taking into consideration those feedbacks, you can say both criticism as well as your positives, the people, they can, the business organization, they can build their brand image. So some of the brands like Tata, like Reliance, they are considered as your reliable brands because they have a large customer base, a large satisfied customer base, that I will say. So that's very important in case of your this customer relationship management. So this is all about your CRM up till now. Next business BI application is related to your healthcare and wellness. So everyone knows it in today's world, healthcare and your wellness, it is taking a lot of, you can say, importance in the life of human beings. So what we have to do is, now we have to see what role this BI application has in this or now. Healthcare is one of the biggest sectors in the advanced economies. Now in today's world, healthcare is one of the biggest sectors. Evidence-based medicine is the newest trend in data-based healthcare management. Evidence means whatever symptoms you see in this patient, that is called as evidence. So evidence-based medicine means based on those symptoms, doctor prescribe a medicine to this patient. So even this healthcare management that takes into consideration history of that patient. So what that person medicine that person is taking in, or what kind of you can say already existing diseases a person have, like a person can be a diabetic, a person can be having BP problem. So these things, they are all help these healthcare people to better take decision in terms of what kind of medicine should be prescribed to a patient. So BI applications can help apply the most effective diagnosis and prescriptions for various ailments. So definitely BI applications, they are helping these doctors and the people who are connected to these healthcare system to prescribe better, you can say, medicine, or you can say best medicine in terms of any kind of ailment. So they can help, they can also help manage public health issues and reduce the waste and fraud. So even in case of your public health issues, like publicly, how, what kind of this sanitation system should be there, what kind of facilities should be provided to the large number of people who visit particular, let's say, malls, particular areas in a, this city. And to reduce waste and fraud means waste disposal system should be properly there, so that that should not lead to some kind of health problems to the people around. So, and plus, in case of your fraud, if we say that in case one person has an insurance, medical insurance, so the person should not be having, person should not be defrauded by some company or organization that in that case. So under it, what this BI application includes, like diagnosing the disease in a patient, what kind of disease a patient has, that is based on the previous history of that organization, that patient, plus present symptoms and, you can say, evidence-based these tests. Everyone knows it that to verify that what kind of symptom has, the doctor prescribes some tests also. They are called as evidence-based evidence, so that a doctor can prescribe good medicine to a patient. So first of all, you to diagnose a disease in a patient. Second, treatment effectiveness. So what kind of effectiveness treatment would have in terms of medicines, in terms of different tests that are being prescribed to a particular patient. And like we say that if 100 patients, they were prescribed, let's say, medication for your this hypertension, that is high blood pressure. So we'll see that whether it was controllable. So whenever the medicines are prescribed at the behind or your these companies, they do a lot of research work. First of all, they gather data based on the effectiveness of the salt that they are using for controlling this hypertension. And then they see that if the results on the large number of people that was really effective, then only that becomes a medicine. And they manufacture that medicine, provide that information to the doctors. And in that case, that helps a large number of patients of hypertension to be treated. Again, another important factor is wellness management. And this includes keeping track of patient health records, analyzing those customer health records, and advising them to take any needed precautions for further in their life. So you have some kind of ailment, like say you have your this diabetes. So doctor normally suggests you to avoid anything that is having your carbohydrates, or let's say anything having your sweet, that means your sugar and other things. So that is your wellness management. So if you have a large amount of data available in the form of BI tool or application regarding your patient, that would definitely help doctors to better guide you, better take your precautions, and analyze your health, and better treat you. Manage fraud and abuse. So some of the medical practitioners, they have a habit of conducting unnecessary tests and overbilling you. So in that case, what happens is they have, if you if they don't know about your symptoms, they don't know about any kind of BI this data available regarding a patient, in that case the fraud can be there. If you, your data is available to the doctor, so the chances of fraud is very less, because the companies who are providing medical insurance, they definitely go for, they ask the doctor why you are prescribing these tests to the these patients, so that the fraud is not there. Public health management. The management of public health is one of the important responsibilities of any government. Everyone knows it. For that, what happens is they use different tools to know what kind of diseases can occur in an area based on the environment that is there. If there is a lot of waste that is available at different locations in the city, that will definitely lead to a lot of health problems in and around that area. Or there is a, that, let's say, due to rain, a lot of water starts standing at a particular area. So that would be a breeding ground for a lot of mosquitoes, and that would lead to some kind of diseases in that area. So that is all that comes under your public health management. So it is the responsibility of the government, and it uses different kind of BI tools to help tackle any kind of public health, you can say, problems that occur during the different scenarios.